So, if you guys are brand new to this series, my name's Unite the Clans, and this is a Minecraft walk-a-thon. Farlands or bus style, but without an end goal. We're just walking because life in the woods, especially with Sildur's shaders, is the most gorgeous version of Minecraft I've ever come across. Good morning, guys. What is going on? Unite the Clans here, back in yo life with another episode of Life in the Woods. And I've been doing some work. As you can see, I've set up like I promised, and I learned a little bit about how to cook food. The one thing that I'm having trouble finding is eggs. There are chickens around here, and I've sort of dug a chicken trap and let a few of them in here, and we'll see if there are any eggs waiting. No eggs. Yes! Beautiful. I haven't made a ladder, though, so how do I get out? Whatever, we'll grab that one egg, and I think we can use that to make mayo. And we'll see if, before we hit the road, we'll see if... Oh, get back in there, you little... Okay. One chicken lost. See, this is why you gotta have a ladder in your chicken pit. And you will be turned into meat. Perfect. So guys, we are going to get back on track today. We are going to continue our endless westward journey. But before we do, I wanted to see if I had in fact learned how to make a few things. This is my little hut. I use these little Japanese lanterns I've been carrying around forever and put them up in here. And we are going to attempt to make some food. This is my chest, mostly of crap I'm leaving behind, but I suppose I'm going to need some of this. Let's get rid of these torches while we're here. We'll decorate the joint. Let's put one there and one there. Perfect. And then what else in here do I want to take with me? The seeds? Nah, none of this. I think we're good. So, we are going to attempt to make some food. Let's start with a burger. Okay, the burger. So that requires toast, which I've made by putting bread in the oven, a frying pan or a skillet, which I've got, and then some meat. So that's really easy. And I've made a second backpack. The black one is for food stuff. So we'll grab the skillet. What was the other thing? Toast, which I've got here, and beef. Was it cooked beef or raw beef? We'll find out in a minute. Raw beef. Perfect. This is a learning experience for me as much as it is for you guys. Oh, yes! 8 hamburgers. Okay, let's grab this meat. And while we're here, guys, I think it would be wise to make more burgers. So let's make... I have 6 more. Let's make 6 more. I think I only need one then. 6 more toast. Perfect. And then let's see what else we can do in the burger department. Cheeseburger. I don't have cheese yet. I think I gotta take a bucket to a cow. Ooh, bacon. Oh, it's a bacon cheeseburger. Shoot, so you can't do anything without the cheese. Deluxe cheeseburger. It's got lettuce and tomato. I got the tomato. Bacon mushroom burger. But I can't do anything without cheese. Okay, so we're stuck with burgers. Let's see about chicken. I know I've got some chicken. And I know that there is such a thing as a chicken sandwich, which is here. Requires mayo, which requires a juicer, which I have, and an egg. So we could look into the tofu thing. Juicer. Okay, so let's get this out. Juicer. And then we'll combine the two. Juicer. And where's our... Didn't we grab an egg? Yes, one egg. Let's make a pot of mayo. Yowz. Perfect. All right, we're learning. And then chicken sandwich. Give me the rest of the leafy chicken sandwich. No. Let's see if there's any other chicken sandwich. That's a different chicken sandwich. That requires bell peppers, which there's a crop growing. I want to see if we can clear it out before we hit the road. So bread, mayo, chicken, and the skillet. So skillet, regular uncooked bread, which I've put all in here. So let's get this back. I have in this backpack, I've got this stuff. How much chicken do we have? Let's just take all this. Remind me, is it a cooked chicken or I think it's cooked chicken in this case? Raw. Okay. Raw chicken. How much raw chicken do we have? 7. So we're going to want 7 bread. So that's 1. Whoops. Give me that. All right. By the way, guys, I'm such a liar. I think it says right in the description, no fancy meals. but I couldn't help but show this to you as I'm learning. I think the no fancy meals thing was mainly out of fear of having to learn all this stuff. So here we go. Oh, I don't have enough mayo for all this. Okay, we're making one chicken sandwich. We got extra bread and clearly extra chicken. So one chicken sandwich, burgers. We got obviously the fruit salad. I made this stock. So let's see about making some soups. Let's see if that's an option. Tomato soup. Oh, we can definitely do that. What? Cactus soup. Get that nasty stuff out of my face. What are you? Seeds. Okay, so any sort of seed? What is the soup called? Seed soup. Interesting. Okay, and that involves the pot, which I have right here. So let's try the tomato soup. So we'll go pot with one stock and a tomato. Perfect. Oh, life is good, guys. We are learning. Let's go see if we can't get some of those seeds and try and make some seed soup. That could be interesting. None of this is grown. Asparagus crop. No, none of it's grown either. So maybe we'll grab some asparagus seeds and we'll see about seed soup. An asparagus seed soup. I think that's going to be plenty. So let's head back to my place, which is just over here. And guys, I'm so stoked. This is so much fun. And that, you know, that some of you guys are excited and watching this series gets me excited. So you laying any eggs down there, you lazy? All right, where's my house? So let's try seed soup. I've got more than enough for all the stock that I've made, which you make just by putting, I think, a pot with a bone or a piece of ham, pork chop, whatever you call it. So seed soup will require a pot. 5 stock and 5 seeds. Yows! Beautiful. And I think, give me that back. I think I'm going to leave the rest of these seeds here. I'm just going to throw in everything we're not planning on using right now, including our tools and supplies, into this backpack. And man, it's full already. We are stocked up. Totally stocked up. There's some portobellos. Once we have cheese for our burgers, which I'll make a bucket and we'll try and milk some cows as we go by. And I think I'm just going to eat this seaweed as we go. And I've made a bow, which goes here. Guys, I think we're ready to roll. Let's grab our basics here. Give me my bed. I really shouldn't have done that. Why did I take that bed? This was our spawn point. Idiot. Oh, give me this. And everything that goes inside. I'll take this. And I'll take this. And you know what? Perfect. It's nighttime. I'm going to put that dang bed back. We're going to stay the night here. And in the morning, we will set out to continue our journey. It's going to be beautiful. Guys, I'll come right back with you. All right. Farewell house. Farewell village. And where's the sun rising? I think it's over there. Yes. So if you guys are brand new to this series, my name's Unite the Clans, and this is a Minecraft walk-a-thon, Farlands or Bust style, but without an end goal. We're just walking because life in the woods, especially with Sildur's shaders, is the most gorgeous version of Minecraft I've ever come across, and I want to see as much of it as possible along our endless journey. And one thing that we've done, I mean, I've kind of slacked in the last couple episodes, but we have continually in this series sort of talked about being a better person, motivation and inspiration. And what have we got here? It's not a road or anything. Okay, cool. And today, guys, I wanted to talk about ego. Now, the idea that most people have of ego is someone who is egotistical, who is cocky, who is sometimes just confident, but is self-assured. And I mean, sometimes you picture an arrogant person, but in general, guys, the most self-assured, the most self-confident, and the most self-aware people have almost no ego. And when I talk about it, I mean it in the way that, like, if someone says something to you that you take as a slight, like, I wish I had a good example off the top of my head. Let's say in your job, I'm a bartender, but let's say someone goes, oh, you probably don't know how to make that drink. And your first instinct is, well, how dare you? I'm a bartender. I know how to make whatever I want to make. Who are you to say that about me? That's your ego. You know what else is your ego? And this is the most obvious one ever. Oh, is that a witch's hut? I think we'll probably steer clear of that if you guys are cool with it. The most obvious example ever. You guys ever get coffee in a coffee shop? Yeah. And if so, do you ever leave a tip? I do. You know when you leave your tip and you wait until the person who's there is looking so they can see you leave the tip and know what a good person you are? That's your ego. If you really cared about leaving a tip because you wanted to make the waiter or the barista's life a little bit better, it doesn't matter if they see it. In fact, it's almost better if they don't. Now, when I talk about somebody who does their best to avoid their ego, one good example, I spend a lot of time listening to podcasts, and one of the best ones out there is the Joe Rogan Experience. Now, you guys may shake your head and go, the guy from the UFC, the guy from Fear Factor, believe me, it's worth your time. They're tremendous. I've been listening for probably over 5 years, a long time, to that podcast. And Joe, every once in a while, will do what he calls a love bomb, where he'll take a $100 bill, slip it into you know, the billfold at a restaurant or into a barista's tip jar, and just run like hell. Get the heck away from there as fast as possible. And the good feeling, guys, shouldn't come from... The good feeling of leaving a tip shouldn't come from... oh, I'm a good person now. Look how good I am. No, it should come from... Look at how happy I might have just made that person. Whether it's a 25-cent tip with your cup of dark roast, or it's, you know, $100 dropped in a billfold at a steakhouse. Hi, cutie. What are you? A little mouse. If I want to make their day better, or I just want to thank them for the service, just drop the money and go. Ideally when they're not looking, so that you're not distracted by your ego. Left or right? Left or right? I think we're going left. Okay. Oh, that's weird. Okay. Yes. Okay. We've found something. Hell yes. Okay, so I'm going to be distracted from my topic for a while. This is a stable. It's a horse stable. If we find a saddle here, guys, oh, it'll be a game changer. Oh. There's a name tag. My horses need fodder. Hello, sir. Do you have a saddle? Shoot. Oh, I was so stoked that there'd be a saddle hiding in this place. My horses need... Damn it. I should kill a horse in vengeance. Enjoy your stupid horses, idiot. How about sharing a saddle with a poor, lonely traveler? And oh dang, we just found another village, guys. Wow, we went like 13,000 blocks without ever finding one. Speaking of, I'm going to get that crap off your screen. Sorry if it was up the whole time. I apologize. Okay, another village. Now, we don't want to stay here forever. I just spent a week in a village, basically, it feels like. So, oh yes, carrots. And I'm not going to break things that we can't take with us. I just want whatever we can get our hands on. More potatoes, perfect. Okay, more crops. Way more crops, and a church, and some big buildings. Oh, I'm stoked. All right, guys. I'm clearly distracted from my topic, but we'll get back to it when we start walking again. Devil's shoestring. All right. Oh, I should be using my... I don't know if it actually helps, but I'm going to use this thing. It's supposed to help me get... See? One carrot. I don't know what I'm supposed to use it for. Oh, I get two. I might be getting two once in a while, guys. Or maybe that's just how carrots look. I don't know, I haven't looked at a carrot in this game in a long time, especially in its floating form. Gimme yowse. Back off, fool. I'm taking everything you got that's valuable. What's in here? Nothing. We have been blessed lately, I gotta say, guys, that just a crazy diversity of stuff we've found, and now two villages in two episodes. Life is good. How do you get into your church? Hello? Oh, that's why. Hello, sir? Clay, okay. That's not helpful. I don't think there's actually anything helpful in a church, is there? No. Blacksmith shop? It doesn't look like we get one. We'll just check these last couple buildings and we'll see. Oh yeah! Perfect. They contain bookshelves. I don't think we're ever going to get into enchanting in this series, so we'll leave that be. And I gotta make sure I eat some of this seaweed. Good, we're almost through it. That one's empty. That's the same one I stayed in last time. I think we're done, guys. I think this village has given us everything it has to give. Oh, and night is upon us. Okay, so I guess another night in another village. But that'll be all we do here, guys. I'll throw a bed in one of these houses. And in the morning, we'll continue the journey over that way. And I'll come back with you. Can't wait. Alright, deja frickin' vu. I'm not breaking the bed this time. Rise and shine, guys. We got another day, and hopefully another many miles ahead of us. The sun is rising where? I get distracted over there, so we're going this way. And we will say farewell to this village and all its many horses, and that villager that lives just outside of town, not sharing his saddles with the poor travelers like me and like you guys, as you are joining me on this journey. I consider you part of this. Let's get that bed off the hotbar, and I suppose I'm gonna have to find a way to get all this stuff into my inventory. We'll worry about that as we go. Let's drop that, and while we're here, let's grab this food backpack, and we're gonna eat the first of our prepared meals, a chicken sandwich with mayo. Ready? Oh yeah, that fills you right up. Beauty. That's a game changer too. Get this crap out of my inventory. Don't want it. Alright, guys. So, before we left, we were talking about your ego. And it is not something you're ever going to get rid of. Whoa, hi, Spidey. Get ready to be wrecked by me. Okay, come on, fool. Alright. Oh, this is a cool biome, too. I think, honestly, the best way to start trying to limit the influence of your ego and your thoughts and your decisions, guys, is to just pay attention to it. Little moments like the ones I talked about are things that I had never taken the time to think about. I just sort of let my thoughts be my thoughts, and I've never realized what it is that's really influencing them. And I think that's what I mean when I talk about self-awareness, is taking the time to realize why you think the way you think. All the things from your youth, your parents, your teachers that have had those influences on your decisions and the way that you handle problems. It's funny, we can get through a lot of our life without taking the time to start thinking for ourselves. Because from the time you're a kid, like I said, your parents, your teachers, the other adults you spend time around, they program you, basically. I mean, they teach you how to act and how to behave. I see desert ahead, guys, and as treacherous as it is, I think this will be a fun time to bring you back, because the desert is gorgeous. We've just been going through these viney trees, and I kind of have to bring you back, because I feel like I got too much to talk about. I spent the first half of the episode on ego, and I barely even got to the freaking point. I'm just gonna try and avoid everything, because it seems like everything in here could sting you. But, oh, there's my Skype with a little blurb. Perfect. The most important thing, guys, that you need to think about with ego is how it affects your thoughts negatively, right? Our ego is the thing that makes us think about the future. You know that voice in the back of your head that says, oh, I'll never, this relationship's over, I'll never find the perfect person, or for me, I get it from time to time where I get really down, going like, oh god, I've been working on this YouTube channel for a year and I don't even have 500 subscribers. Blah, blah, blah. That, you know what that voice is, guys? That's your ego. And pretty much anytime you think about the future with anxiety and with fear, god dang, is that not your ego that's talking? Because to be honest, oh, see, there you go, prickly pears everywhere. The future doesn't exist yet, and a lot of people, including me, and I'm sure including you guys, spend a ton of time thinking about it and worrying about it. I think I'm going to try and get the boat out here. And it honestly, it only exists in our mind. Yeah, you may find the perfect person, or you may never find anybody that you desperately love. You know, my channel may remain this size for all eternity, or it may grow and it may, you know, be the biggest joy in my life. I have no idea how it's going to go. And me spending time worrying about it and losing sleep over it, that is an ego. That's my ego saying, here's who I think I want to be, and here's why I'm frustrated or anxious, because I'm not that person yet, right? And that's where it's destructive. That's where working on it and trying to avoid it or silence it, I suppose, you're never going to win, guys. It's not easy to control your own ego and to control your own thoughts and to stay positive. But just know that a lot of the time that negativity, that self-doubt, that fear, that anxiety, that's coming from that voice in your head that says, I want to be bigger and better than what I am, or I want to be more loved and I'm afraid I never will be, or, you know, a thousand little thoughts like that, right? And I'm going to talk with the time we have left in this episode about some ways that, like I said, this is not an easy journey. You are not going to be able to do something tomorrow that silences your ego and makes you endlessly happier, but you can work on it. And I think step one, guys, is not this. I mean, you can choose to control your thoughts, and step one is love. Choose whenever it comes up, whenever you have that moment of doubt, that moment of fear, that moment of, you know, jealousy over someone else, choose love. Choose to love that person. Choose to love yourself. And when you're in a quandary, when you are feeling that crazy anxiety, just remember that if you don't love you, nobody's going to do it. We're hustling because sunset is coming up. I've luckily got a bed prepared, so we don't need to panic or anything like that, but I do want to get I always want to get over the horizon. I guess that's it, right? All right, guys, that is the first and hopefully only crash in today's episode. We are going to stop right here. I'm going to get this out, and I guess I'm going to have to move some crap in here to make room for my bed, which hopefully we can slap down before any trouble arrives. Done. Perfect. I will see you guys in the morning. All right, we're up. Sun rising in the east, so we head west. Guys, I finished off last night talking about that, about loving yourself and loving the people around you and not letting those negative thoughts slip in. Because they all come from that ego, that wanting to, I don't know, this idea of self that we have, that built up where we're lying to ourselves, going, I'm this, I'm that, and you're not yet, or you're just trying to be. I definitely fit that category, guys. I will start doing something new, like working out, or even just a daily ritual of making my bed, and then I'll just be the one running around bragging about, oh yeah, you gotta make your bed every day. Oh dude, you haven't even done that yet. That's my ego going, oh, look who I think I am. I think I'm the guy who makes his bed every day because it has some sort of meditative value for him. That's just yet another example of my own ego, which slips up on this channel all the time, guys, pretending to be something or someone I'm not. I'm in a desperate, continual struggle to just be myself on here as much as I can make it happen. So, guys, the next sort of thing you can do is do your best to focus on positivity. A lot of the negativity that we experience in our thoughts is driven by our egos. And if you can choose to be positive, if the number one thing is to avoid complaining. If you complain, if you fret, if you sort of whine about what's going on in your life instead of taking the time to take an active step and work towards changing it, then you and I couldn't even be friends, guys. It's really important to me that people don't just sit back and complain about what's going on with them. take some time and make it better. You control everything in your own life, or you can control a lot in your own life. And when people get that feeling of hopelessness, it's often because they feel as though they can't control anything. And that is often where that complaining comes from. And if you can focus a little bit of your time on positivity and make sure that your thoughts stay positive, look what we found. Tell me we got something good. Oh, Lord, there's so much stuff in here. Okay, well, I'm going to have to come back here and grab it and sort out my inventory. But let me take a minute and sort of just finish talking about what I was talking about, because we're coming up to the end of this episode anyway, guys. This little spot is a perfect one for me to end at. In fact, I think I'll probably set up a little base and see if I can turn some of this food that's in here. It looks mostly like fish, yeah, grouper, walleye, octopus, water breathing potions, a crazy good fishing rod. Yeah, I think I'm gonna have to take some time and see what I can turn that into. At the very least, I might need a second food backpack, so I'll have to kill some cows around here for leather. But the last thing, guys, the last thing I'm going to ask you to do in the process of kind of limiting your own ego is to be thankful. And I've talked about this in that series before, but take a minute and be thankful that you wake up in a warm bed, in a safe house, in a place that's ideally that you've chosen to live because it's perfect for you. Take a moment to do that. Take a moment to be grateful for the pot of coffee that you get to wake up to, or the cup of tea, or whatever it is that you can just drive to the grocery store and grab a meal. Take a moment to be grateful for the fact that you have a job. And the more that you can take those moments, guys, the more you will silence that nagging, frustrating, anxious voice that's called your ego. I like this episode, guys. I like that we've gotten back to the format I started with a few weeks back of trying to motivate and inspire you guys. I've also tried to take on big things from my to-do list. I've had 4 days in a row off work, guys. The grass in my house is ridiculously long, and my goal for today, the thing that I promise I'm gonna do after turning off this recording, is head out, cut down my dang grass. I know that doesn't sound like a big deal, but I'm a epic endless procrastinator, and if I don't make little promises to you guys to get important things in my life done, I just won't get them done. And with that in mind, I am thankful that you guys are here, that you're watching this series, and that I have this free way to motivate myself. But guys, that is going to do it for this episode of Life in the Woods. My name is Unite the Clans. If you have made it this far into this video, if you are watching any of my content and you're not subscribed, guys, please do it. I think with the number of views I have, I'd like to have another 40, 50, 60 subscribers. So if you're watching and you haven't done that yet, do me a big favor. Make my ego feel a little bigger and a little better and subscribe. And maybe tell a friend. Because if you've made it this far, if you've made it to the end of this 20-odd minute video, you're the kind of person that I want watching my stuff. Guys, thank you again for watching, and I will see you all in the next episode.